Let me see, that's football, meat pies, kangaroos and Holden cars, huh?
Right!
Well, you sure sound like Australia to me.
So many of us grew up in a Holden, childhood spent in the back of a beat-up Kingswood or Commodore. At its peak, it was a manufacturing behemoth. But today, Holden's parent company, General Motors, called time on the quintessential Aussie icon.
We have just informed our employees and our dealer partners, and I can confirm to you that GM has taken the very difficult decision to wind down Holden operations in Australia and New Zealand by 2021.
It's been a long, sad death for the company that last year posted its worst sales figures since 1954.
I'm disappointed, but not surprised. But I am angry, like I think many Australians would be. Australian taxpayers put billions into this multinational company, and they let the brand just wither away on their watch.
The last Holden made in Australia rolled off the assembly line in 2017, and in 2019 it was announced the Commodore and the Astra would both be discontinued.
It's a sad day for manufacturing in Australia.
General Motors has been retreating from right-hand drive countries like Australia, which only make up 25% of the global market. Around 600 people will lose their jobs by the end of the year.
It's going to be a sad day to lose the Holden brand because, you know, like all of us, that's what we've grown up, you know, seeing Holdens and Fords, you know, around on the streets of Adelaide.
Despite the Holden's slow decline, it was a shock announcement and one that will be deeply felt across all of Australia.
Holden has been ubiquitous, deeply integrated into our landscape, streetscape and culture, and will continue to be. So from Holden, I thank you.
Paul Marich is a motoring journalist and he joins us. Now, Paul, what if you just bought a Holden last week? What does it mean for you then?
Look, it's not the end of the world. You are still getting a fantastic car that's great to drive. Holden has committed to retaining around 200 of the 800 staff that have lost their jobs to look after things like warranties, spare parts and also servicing for cars that are bought from today onwards.
For how long?
For 10 years.
OK. Well, it's something, I suppose. The bit that caught my eye there, though, was that apparently building right-hand drive cars, so like we have in countries where you drive on the left side of the road, is less popular because those countries aren't as common. If General Motors is making that decision, will other car manufacturers start making that decision and then it gets harder for Australians to buy cars?
Yeah, look, they could. GM is an American company. Obviously, a lot of left-hand drive cars in the States. 75% of the world's car population is actually left-hand drive. Now, the thing that bemuses me, though, is what's the government doing about this? Why can't we just have left-hand drive cars in Australia? It'd massively open up the market. And it's not like it would be the only place in the world where that happens. If you go to the UK, you can drive left-hand drive or right-hand drive because you zip over to Europe and Bob's your uncle.
Paul, the Ford-Holden rivalry is basically buried and dead now. But what's this going to mean for Red Bull 888 racing in the V8s?
Well, they had an agreement until the end of next year for Holden to supply everything they needed to make that team happen. So it's up in the air at the moment. No one actually knows what's happening. Holden says that they're still caught up in the big rush of all the news and they haven't sat down to have a look at racing, which is a little bit concerning because Holden claims they only found out 48 hours ago that GM will be pulling support for Australia.
I haven't had a look at it. Wow, it sounds like a big decision without actually having had a look at something that's big business. Paul, thank you very much for your help. Appreciate it.
Thanks, guys.
A really sad day. I mean, I know it's been a long death and it's been a long and winding road and it's taken a long time and the last car rolled off the production line in 2017. But I grew up in Adelaide, which was a Holden town. I lived for a year in Elizabeth, which was the main production plant was in Elizabeth. My dad sold Holdens for 60 years.
Wow.
He passed away a couple of years ago. But we always had a Holden in the driveway. I owned just about every one of those Holdens that you saw in that piece at the beginning. And it's just a reflection on how we've let manufacturing in this country largely disappear. But, I mean, we have 70 car brands in this country and we only have 1% of the car sales globally. So it's the most competitive market in the world. And Holden, Ford, when I was growing up, you had Holden, Ford, Nissan, Mitsubishi, all making cars, most of them in South Australia, and it's all just gone.
Yeah, but it's partly about taste as well, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, we don't have this day if Australians are buying Holdens.
Correct. And the big family sedan with a six-cylinder motor simply got overtaken and eaten by the SUVs.
Yeah.